depending on angle of viewing.
Angle of
viewing. Okay. The world is a perception. If you say I am the body. If you look at from the body point of view, world is a perception. I am the body, the world is a perception. If you look at mind point of view, the world is nothing but a thought. Okay? Experience of world is called a feeling from the mind point of view. From body point of view, it's a perception. From intellect point of view, it's an idea. From consciousness point of view, nothing.
Zero.
Okay? How you look at the world depends on where you stand. Right? So I am telling you again and again, come back to the stand that I am consciousness. Others, you are already stuck in some ideas, thoughts, feelings. Again and again, I come back to consciousness point of view. Then there's nothing else. Then anything else comes, you create that. There's a creation. So at the body point of view, there's karma. Body and mind point of view, there's karma. From the consciousness point of view, there's no karma. Okay? Understand? So again and again, you have to go to consciousness point of view and become free from karma. Don't get stuck with the body point of view. From body point of view and mind point of view, there's memory. From consciousness point of view, the memory gets replaced by power of imagination, shakti. The language changes as you change the domain. You understand? The language changes as you change your domain, where you're operating. Okay? So you have to learn how to switch the domain and operate from a higher domain in the lower plane. Right now in your prayers and puja, are you in the lower plane and you are seeking higher plane? You don't even know that you can go there. Okay? You are praying. The moment you say, I am in the higher plane, then lower plane becomes your playground, the field. Okay? Right now the lower plane has become your jail.
So the difference between the destiny and free will is you living in the power of creative power. Of the present.
That's all. So, that's what I want to say. So, if you are a body, if you are a body, right? I am body. Okay, I'll take this. I am body. So then, world is real.
Perception.
Okay? Perception is reality. Right? So, karma is law of karma. Karma is real.
Trapped in karma.
Trapped in karma.
Yes.
Okay. Memory is real. You understand? Now the moment you say I am
mind.
Okay. The world is thought. What?
Real.
What?
Okay, if no, sir, you just complete it. I'll try to understand.
I am mind, world is thought.
Okay.
Okay. Memory is real. Because still you are at thought level, you are separate. Mm-hmm. Law of karma
is real.
Is real. Okay. So I am intellect, buddhi, slightly higher than the mind. World is an idea.
Okay.
Right? Memory is real.
Law of karma is also
real. Law of karma is also
real.
Real. Right? So I am Sakshi.
Leave that column blank.
Why?
Sakshi doesn't have any
world. No, no, world is actually world.
Does not exist.
Memory? No, it exists. It is Maya. Memory. Maya.
Everything is Maya.
World, memory,
karma.
Is all world. World is appearing moment to moment. No past, future. No karma. Okay? No karma.
No memory.
No memory. So now you go to point of view called I am Brahman. Sakshi is also Brahman, but Sakshi, Brahman watching what the hell is happening.
In my heaven, no, what the hell other. Is happening?
Non-dual. Right? You understand? So, you have to shift where you stand depends on the. So they say, where I stand actually, this is the question. Not really, this is all I'm creating, this moment to moment. I didn't even think of last
moment. Because you are Brahman.
Brahman, what are you doing?
I told you.
Where you stand?
Check your status.
What you? Experience. Check your
status.
This is what is called Brahmada.
Okay. So that's why Ramakrishna Paramahamsa used to say, what you say does not matter. Who says matter? Okay, I'll Ramakrishna Paramahamsa's quotation I'll put in. I'll tell you what it means. What you say does not matter. Who says matters? Ramakrishna. Ramakrishna. Yakappa podidira. Simple, ನಿಮ್ಮ ಎಕ್ಸ್ಪೀರಿಯನ್ಸ್ ಆಫ್ ಲೈಫ್ ಇದು. ಅಲ್ಲಪ್ಪ, ಇದು ನಿಮ್ಮ ಲೈಫ್ ಎಕ್ಸ್ಪೀರಿಯನ್ಸ್. ಡಿಪಿ ಸ್ಟೇಟಸ್. ಓಕೆ,
ವೇರ್ ಯು ಸ್ಟ್ಯಾಂಡ್ ಎವ್ರಿಥಿಂಗ್.
ಹಾ, ವೇರ್ ಯು ಸ್ಟ್ಯಾಂಡ್. ಓಕೆ, ರಾಮಕೃಷ್ಣ ಪರಮಹಂಸ ಇಸ್ ಟು ಸೇ, ವೇರ್ ಯು ಸ್ಟ್ಯಾಂಡ್, ವೇರ್ ಯು, ವಾಟ್ ಯು ಸೇ, ಇಟ್ ಡಸಂಟ್ ಮ್ಯಾಟರ್. ಹೂ ಸೇಸ್ ಮ್ಯಾಟರ್ಸ್. Why is that so? So you go in, you are going in the road, or you are going on the road, and he says too much of dirt is there. What a dirty place the same. Okay? So then, Modi ji comes on that road. He just looks at the dirt, he doesn't even say anything. The whole road dirt gets cleaned up. Disappears. What is the difference?
Who says
matters. Okay? So that's where, why it is said that? Because who, when you say who, it's not about a body and mind. With what consciousness you speak makes a difference. Okay? If I say same teaching to you, whether the body and mind and complex, then the teaching will have less effect. It won't change your life. If I speak to you as Brahman or consciousness, that will have changes in your life. So that's why you have to seek the teaching from a realized master, not a person who thinks he is a body and mind. This is the difference.
Does it all depend on how we listen from consciousness point of view?
Yeah, but see, you will not get a... depending on who is listening, he will not get a highest level master just like that. If he's ready, only he'll get it. When the student is ready, the teacher appears, it says that. That maturity has to come. Otherwise, he'll go to such a teacher, he will listen to everything and does some namaskara and comes home happy, oh, my promotion will come. His understanding will change. But the conviction in the teacher brings the conviction in you. Clear? Ashwini, any questions? So where do you stand now?
Between Sakshi and Brahman.
Between Sakshi and Brahman, there is nobody. Who is there between Sakshi and Brahman?
Freedom to create new post.
Freedom to create new post. Is it clear, Anupa? So, you see the world, okay? And even if, let's say, assume that there's memory is there. Even if you assume the world is, memory is real. What is it, memory? You are seeing the world. You are seeing the world through very limited sense organs. Means you are taking only small piece of what is there and out there. Okay? Then the mind is interpreting that. And recording that. That means whatever you are experiencing, a fraction of that, only small things gets recorded. Some abstraction is done in the memory. Let's say memory is real. Then you talk about yourself. Okay? Your talk about yourself is also what other people say. So some amount gets recorded as me. Something gets recorded as world. The I never gets recorded at all, the real I. Does it get recorded anytime? When you take a photograph, the photographer will never come. Sakshi is the... Selfie also doesn't come. Photographer is Sakshi. Then the Sakshi will come. Photographer is one who is viewing. Sakshi. He'll never come. So your memory recording about yourself is false. Because it doesn't contain the real I. And whatever I it comes is all not because of you, because somebody else has told it's you. Okay, your identity given by the world, and world identity itself is also
false.
I can't say false, it's just a fraction, not totality. So with this we have to make our living. Okay, we are like a blind man living in a trying to find a way out in the forest. Everything somebody says gets hurt, you get hurt. But what you don't understand is, it's not you who is getting hurt. It is the identity created by society that gets hurt. Right? What is in your head is your identity. And you start living that I am that identity. And society knows how to hurt it also, because society only created the identity, no? Then they will call you donkey. Then you'll get hurt, because society knows your identity gets hurt by donkey. So like that, your identity is also false. Your world is also false, and you think you are living in the real world. How is it possible, sir?
It's partial.
Huh?
Because of pieces, it is partial.
It is actually lot of small, small pieces.
Because body mind is limited, you can't grasp the bigger whole completely.
You can't grasp it.
It will only cut it into pieces.
It will cut into pieces, fill up with assumptions.
Jigsaw puzzles that don't actually match.
So now what will happen? In that you are trying to make a figure out and leaving. Right?
So Prabhuji, what about the other way? Now as a body mind, if I have an idea of Brahman, that is also pieces.
It's not partial, it's not even true. You cannot have
an
idea
it's
of Brahman.
It's only an idea. It's an intellectual concept.
Right? So now what happens is you are living in a paradise, it's called fool's paradise, thinking it's real. And this is what's called Maya. This is what Shankaracharya refers to Maya. You don't understand the world called Maya, Maya, Maya. Maya means you are using a picture or imagination in your head, whatever is that, and thinking it's real. Nothing is real about it. Only I is real. The photographer never comes in the photo. You are the photographer. You never come in the photo. But you start living as if the photo is you. This is the illusion. Your photo is you, your friend's photo is a friend, your enemy's photo is enemy. And see, just small imagination also causes so much of disturbance in our mind. For imaginary photo, imaginary disturbance, and imaginary life. Your disturbance is also imaginary. Nothing real. What life you are living? Tell me. Start living in reality. I am consciousness, I am Sakshi, I am Brahman. That's real life. But never tell anybody, because in their head your picture is there, your photo is there. Hey, this lady, no, I only saw yesterday. Okay. So there, it's not your job to remove their images. It's your job to remove your images.
Is that not an idea?
No. See, Brahman, you have to understand. Only, see, you have everything is limited for you. Everything you have to only understand through body, mind, and intellect. There's nothing else.
Okay.
Out of that, intellect only can take you to a higher level. Idea level. Senses cannot take you to some level. Senses can have limitation. Intellect has the ability to point out to something which is not available in your field of vision directly. Provide idea is clear. Now that idea, intellect is stuck with the lot of belief systems and concepts. It cannot come out. So with that, I am the body, I am the mind, I am the intellect, is a belief system in the intellect. Now as it starts dissolving, so you have to give a newer identity, which is called I am Brahman. Now Brahman, what is Brahman? You have to understand very clearly from scriptures and all. You get a clarity about Brahman in the intellectual clarity first.
So that is not a belief system.
No, I'm saying that's also a belief. That's the belief. Now this belief is used for cancelling the wrong beliefs, earlier beliefs. Okay, then Brahman cannot remain as belief. Brahman is I am. So you can know Brahman as I am Brahman, not a thought. That what you are experiencing is existence, you are experiencing. You don't need a proof of that. You don't need belief of that. Are you conscious? Is there a proof required for that? Do you exist? See, it's self-evident to you. That self-evident is called Brahman. Now the intellect is corrupted. I am the body, I am the mind, intellect. That belief system is there. That removal only is teaching is required.
But still the intellect is looking for proof initially.
No, that's not. The proof will come only in the form of
only
Guru.
When you cancel the I am the body.
No, I'm saying the proof. First proof is required some authenticity in terms of Guru. Some authenticity in the form of Vedantic teaching. So the confidence that this is real. Okay, then you have to tell the given method, prakriyas, how to eliminate. Then come to a clarity. Then you come to a clarity, you cannot say, I know Brahman. If you say, I know Brahman, Brahman is an idea. So if you say, I am Brahman, that's the reality. What you call as I am is Brahman. Okay, that's not an idea. That's not a concept. That's your self evident for you. Right? That's not a mantra. That's your experience. You are, I am, when you say I am Brahman, you replace it. I am consciousness. See, that's what you are. Now you are living with the illusion, I am the body, I am the mind, I am the intellect, I am woman, I am man. All are nothing but imaginations in your head. Pictures in your head. Brain. Are we clear? So, the picture is useful, but not real. Because the picture is there, you will go to some house. Otherwise, you will go into somebody else's house. Alright? Because the picture is there, you will have some functioning in the world. Right? You have a useful or meaningful functioning in the world. Based on the pictures. The pictures are imaginary. The functioning is called drama, leela. Any questions? Sudha, you have never, whatever image of you, in your head is not at all you. Your problem is you are again and again going back to that image. You have to learn the real I. Silence, peace. Then you will become free. This image, you cannot cure it. You don't have to repair it. It is unreal anyway. Go back to the reality. Consciousness. Again and again. That will free you from all suffering. Our suffering is because we are again and again going back to the image.
So tuning the image is karma. Karma yoga.
Huh?
Jnana yoga is going back to the reality.
Deleting. Or getting out of the image.
Seeing image as an image.
So that means there is limitation for the power of our senses, whereas there is no limitation for the power, creative power of the present. Is it like that?
I would say the creative power
is
of the...
Is it unlimited or...
It is unlimited. But to the extent of your attunement to...
How you look at it, how you view it.
Where you stand,
exactly. But there is limitation for our power of our senses.
Definitely.
So that can be... We can come out of that by this creative power.
Correct. I don't know who can come out. We can means, I mean, Pune also is included. Then you have to take a power of attorney from her also.
That's
politically correct. I'm going to go to the hospital. ನೋಡ್ರಿ, ನಾವು ಸೀರಿದೇವಳು ಅಲ್ಲಿ ಸೀರೆ ಬೇಕಾದ ಅವ್ರಿಗೆ
ಒಂದು
ದೃಷ್ಟಿಯಿಂದ ಅದು ಸರಿನೇ, ಯಾಕಂದ್ರೆ ಹೋಲ್ಸೇಲ್ ನಿಮ್ಮ ಅಲ್ಲಿ ತಲೆ ಅಷ್ಟೊಂದು ಐಡೆಂಟಿಟಿ ಇದೆಯಲ್ಲ, ನಾನು ಗಂಡಸು ಹೆಂಗಸು ತಾಯಿದ್ದು ಹೋಲ್ಸೇಲ್, ಅದು ಮಲ್ಟಿಪಲ್ ಪರ್ಸನಾಲಿಟಿ ಅದಕ್ಕೆ ಸೇ ವಿ ಅಂತ ಹೇಳೋದು ಕರೆಕ್ಟ್ ಆಗಿದೆ.
Did
you understand what she is saying? Sudha? Huh? No, she says, why people keep on saying we do it. I said, that's a very political way of saying correctly. Okay, I do it means some ego is saying. And the wife says, always she includes husband. Okay? Let us go and buy sari. Sari is for her. Whatever. Let us go and buy a sari. We'll do it.
Let us go together.
So it's a very political way of saying it. One way. Okay. Another way it's correct only. Because when you say we, it's really so. Because you are a wholesale. You are a wife, you are a woman, you are actually multiple personal disorder is there. That's why you say we. So when you say you are Brahman only, you'll tell the truth only. We means the truth only.
The plural.
You mean the respect.
Yeah, plural.
But in the society, if somebody says I now
slap you. Uncomfortable.
ಎಲ್ಲದಕ್ಕೂ ನಾನು ನಾನು
ಓಕೆ
ನಾನು ಇಸ್ ಡಿಫ್ರೆಂಟ್ ಫ್ರಮ್ ದಿಸ್ ನಾನು.
ಸೊ ಲೆಟ್ ಅಸ್ ಗೋ ಟು ಕ್ರಿಯೇಷನ್ ಸೃಷ್ಟಿ. ಓಕೆ ಸೊ ಏನು ಏನು ಕಷ್ಟ ಇಲ್ಲಪ್ಪ, ನೀವು ಯು ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಟು ಟೇಕ್ ಎ ನ್ಯೂ ಐಡೆಂಟಿಟಿ ಅಷ್ಟೇ. ಡೋಂಟ್ ವರಿ ಅಬೌಟ್ ಓಲ್ಡ್ ಐಡೆಂಟಿಟೀಸ್, ಲೈಕ್ ಅಪ್ಲೈ ಯುವರ್ ಓಲ್ಡ್ ಪಾಸ್ಪೋರ್ಟ್ ಯು ಫಾರ್ಗೆಟ್ ಇಟ್, ಅಪ್ಲೈ ಫಾರ್ ನ್ಯೂ ಪಾಸ್ಪೋರ್ಟ್. ಮುಗಿದು ಓಕೆ. ಸೊ the creation, if you think you are a body and mind, the earth was created only a few billion years back, right? That's what scientists think. If you know your sakshi, every moment earth is getting created. When I go out, when I went to toilet and came back, new earth got created. You understand? Every moment to moment new perception arises, that's earth. The creation is moment to moment, not once upon a time. Understand? That's why if you look at our Puranas, if you say Brahmaji created so many years back, so you have to understand for whom the Purana is written. Okay. A person who thinks it's a body, for him it's told that Brahmaji created the universe once upon a time. Okay. So now a person for a Jnani,
so the no beginning.
The Jnani universe is never created. Universe doesn't exist.
Timeless.
Huh?
It is always there.
No, no,
no. It's not
there.
There's no universe. There's no world. I only, Brahman only is there. For a Sakshi, the universe is appearing moment to moment. You understand? Moment to moment because of the power of Sakshi, the imagination. Kalpana Shakti.
Between the
moments,
this
Sakshi. 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 But it's so
fast, people can't catch it. Fast means time is there. And
it appears, perception keep appearing rapidly. So your person has become meditative, for he is able to recognize. That's nothing. That's only consciousness, Brahman only. Any questions? So there are actually you have to see the maturity of a Shastra. If somebody Shastra says the world was created once upon a time, then you understand this is only for people with body and mind. Don't get into that.
What about imagination, sir? Because imagination started somewhere.
It's always there. Always the power of Sakshi, right? The power of fire is burning. Okay. So in Vedanta, for a Jnana Yoga, Jnana teaching, world is, the creation of world is explained in the form of pot. Okay? So the pot is made up of mud. Right? Pot is made up of mud. Pot has a shape. Pot has a form. Pot has a function. Now what do you see on the screen?
The form of pot.
Pot.
Form.
You are not seeing pot, you are seeing mud only. You are calling it as a pot.
Name is form.
Form.
Huh?
Name and form.
Name and form doesn't exist.
No, it is given, but it is...
Name and form is given to mud.
Yes.
Then what you see is mud only. What do you think is?
Mud
only.
Mud and name and form.
But name and form has no independent existence, no?
If I see, close my eyes, I can see a pot, shape of the pot.
So, if I see, I can close my... Okay, now, the pot, the form, is coming because of your sense organs, eyes. So, I will say, the mud shape is given by your eyes. Oh, if you close your eyes, still the mud pot is like that. That's because you are imagining. I am speaking of experience, perception.
Even the mud came from sense organs.
We'll not go to the mud level. We'll go to only mud level. So what I'm saying is the form is because of sense organs. Now I'll wish, I'll give him grant a great boon to Suresh. Your eyes have become X-rays. Okay, like a Superman. Now will you see him at the pot? Perception?
No.
You can't see him at the pot. It'll go through that. And this thing is, what is that? Bat is there. It cannot see the mud pot. There's nothing. There's no eyes. It'll only hear. So what you see depends on the sense organs. It's not reality. Your sense organs are carving out something out of the reality.
Thoughts are.
Huh?
Thought is.
No, thought is name and form. So now you are giving, no, not thought, perception. So now you give a name to that. You say pot. So the pot is actually a mental construct which is given. But what is really there is mud only. Your sense organs and mind are superimposing name and form on that. Right?
So if it is a pot, if there is a glass made of mud, pot and glass, so both are made of mud only, but there are different forms.
Yeah.
So form is having an identity.
No, form, actually, form and function and name together is appearance.
Appearance.
But appearance of what?
Mud.
Appearance of mud.
So what is there is mud only. Appearance can change. Tomorrow you break the pot, but mud cannot change.
Yes.
Right? So similarly, whatever you experience in the world, there is no world. There is only Brahman. Only Brahman, seen as a world because of a limitation of sense organs and the mind. Including you are Brahman. The seeing and the mind superimposes function, name and form on the world and cuts it to pieces. Arthada? Okay, now take your left hand. This left hand exercise you have done?
Yes.
Everybody has done?
Yes.
Last time Somewhere absent, but it was done.
Now.
Yeah, finger.
So finger exercise you are done. So your mind is giving this much is finger only. Finger is here also. Finger is here also. Finger in the world also. So everything is connected. But mind cuts into this thing, and we start believing that it's a reality. That's called Maya. Mind job is only two things: name, form, and function. Then you start saying reality. Separate out. Now how do you come out of this? Just understand the nature of mind and be aware. Why are you again and again getting trapped by the mind's thing? It's useful. Mind is very useful as a servant, but it's a very bad master. So you are suffering in life because mind has become the master and you have become the servant. Mind has become the master and Sakshi has become the servant. Sakshi has to become the master and mind has to become the servant. That's all life.
Why it appears as a shape? What is shape actually? What is, you said sense organs. You so sense organ itself is also, like a material only.
Yeah.
Like it is an object only. Again,
right.
It will be made of consciousness.
Right.
So then again the question appears that how that sense organs occurs. If we go to the direct experience, it is not like that eyes. It is like it is appearing. In the mind it is appearing. It is in somewhere it is appearing, this shape is appearing. Where is this shape comes from?
Comes from this. It appears from consciousness because the power of consciousness, imagine the power of consciousness.
Okay.
You perceive it again back into consciousness. It rises and falls back into consciousness.
How that multiplicity happens, like different shapes, different names, different this one. How that...
This is the power of consciousness. Okay. Now, when you go to deep sleep, the world, the name and form, everything dissolves. Dissolves into what?
Consciousness.
Consciousness. And when you wake up, it gets projected from consciousness. The projecting power of consciousness is called Maya Shakti. Dissolving power of consciousness is called Kundalini. Or the Maya Shakti has two aspects. Projecting power called Avidya Maya. And dissolving power is called Vidya Maya. So Vidya Maya is responsible for this.
I feel that imagination
imagination is very important.
Now from Nana has moved to imagination.
Everything comes to enter the imagination.
Imagination power, yeah. Kalpana Shakti.
Consciousness and imagination power. This is all creation is from that one.
There's no creation. There's only projection.
Projection. Imagination.
Projection. Right? So, you cannot find Brahman because everything is Brahman only. This chair is Brahman. The table is Brahman. In the sense, the form, not the form, the essence. The chair exists. Isness. Isness is Brahman. I exist. I am. Existence is Brahman. So all that is there, the God is everywhere. That's called Vasudeva. Okay? So everything, whatever exists, is existence. You can, existence is seen in the form of fan. Existence is seen in the form of tree. Existence is seen in the form of table. The form changes, but existence doesn't change. Okay, I am also existence. I exist. So I am consciousness. Consciousness and existence is what we are experiencing. Right? So there was a boy called Prahlada. His father was Hiranyakashyapu. Hiranyakashyapu was the father of Prahlada. Hiranyakashyapu used to say that everybody should call his name, nobody should chant Vishnu's name. But Prahlada used to chant name of Vishnu as Vasudeva. Vasudeva means one who is there everywhere. Vasa, Vasati. Vasati lives in all. Wall, mountain, everywhere. That's why Hiranyakashyapu asked him, does he live in this pillar? Then, yes. Then the pillar is broken, Narasimha appeared. So that is actually called Vasudeva Mantra. Vasudeva Mantra means everything is God, everything is consciousness. I am that consciousness, I am that Brahman. Om Namo
Bhagavate
Vasudevaya. Om Namo
Bhagavate
Vasudevaya.
Vasudevaya.
Everything is Brahma. Vasudeva, if you visualize, it is Saguna Brahma. The silence is Vasudeva, Nirguna Brahma. Silence is I. Okay? The mantra has silence and sound. Manifest everything. The mountain, the tree, the wall, the wind, the river, the forest, everything exists. Easiness. Astitva. Existence is called God. Now, are you separate from existence?
No.
I also exist. But there is one separate characteristic is there in you, consciousness. I am conscious, means body-mind complex. That's conscious because of Chidabhasa. The body-mind complex is able to take Chidabhasa. Stone is not able to do that. But stone is existence, I am consciousness. I am existence and consciousness. So, everything is oneness. With that understanding, you have to chant, Om Namo Bhagavate Vasudevaya. Om Namo
Om Namo
Bhagavate
Bhagavate
Vasudevaya
Vasudevaya.
Om Namo
Om Namo
Bhagavate
Bhagavate
Vasudevaya
Vasudevaya.
See, actually Nididhyasa is very simple. Nididhyasa, I have told you what is Nididhyasa. Nidhyasa means everything, whatever is there in the world, convert into consciousness. So, the mountain is there, easiness is there, existence, astitva. Easiness is a thought in my mind. So, mind is a being consciousness. Everything you bring back to consciousness, that's called Nidhyasa. Convert everything into? This is actually called Gujju Buddhi. Gujjus have one Buddhi, Gujjus. Gujaratis. Everything they convert into money. Everything they convert into money. So, in London school, one teacher asked a question. Who is the greatest man on the earth? If you tell, I'll give you £10. So, everybody is scratching their head. Donald Trump, Bill Clinton, Mahatma Gandhi. Then this Gujuba says, Madam, I tell you, Jesus Christ. Madam is so happy. Oh, take 10 pounds, your correct answer. How do you know? How do you tell? You are a Hindu, no? You say, I thought you will tell Krishna. Yes, madam. For me, Krishna is the greatest person. But for you, Jesus Christ. I want 10 pounds. It doesn't matter. Like that. Convert everything into consciousness and become silent. That's all Nididhyasa.
So again check the status where you stand.
Where you stand. So convert everything into consciousness. Everything, a stone is there. There is a form. The form has existence. Chaitanya, Vasudeva. The tree is there. Tree has existence. Vasudeva. I exist. Vasudeva. Vasudeva. That's all Vasudeva. That's all Prahlada understood. That's what Narada taught him. Now what Narada taught him, I am telling you people. Only thing is a bit late. Your Prahlada was told in the womb of the mother.
Long back.
Yeah, it depends on who is out.
Yeah.
Om Namo.
Om Namo.
Bhagavate.
Bhagavate.
Vasudevaya.
Vasudevaya.
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 Sit silently.